you heard? Did you get the word? Gotta get myself a-going. Gotta get my seeds a-sowing. Gotta do my thing. Swing, baby, swing. Got to go. Got to know. Got to see. And I've got to be. Got to do what I want to. Let's do my thing. And swing, baby, swing. Don't get uptight when things ain't right. Hold on tiger, don't lose sight. Hey, do what you can and dig your fellow man. And do your thing and swing, baby, swing. He took a loaf of bread and fed the multitude. Cast your bread upon the water, he'll return to you. Many times fold, you'd be richer than gold. If you do your thing and swing, baby, swing. Got to go, got to know. Got to see and I've got to be. Got to do what I want to. Let's do my thing and swing, baby, swing. As you make your bed, so when you lie, this is what you do before you die. Before I die, there's just one thing. I'll do my thing and swing, baby, swing. Got to go, got to know, got to see, and I've got to be. Got to do what I want to. Let's do my thing and swing, baby, swing. Cause it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. So swing, baby, swing.
All right, all right. Good evening, everybody. Good morning to the East. This is a good program from the Savoy. Hello, everybody. This is Big Daddy, band leader and best player of the Billy Bros Swing Orchestra and radio host, MC, DJ, and all that swing. This is the name of the program. So, really, I mean it, everything that is about swing. Music, culture, history of the 30s and the 40s. I'll do the best I can to entertain you for the next hour while listening to either known and unusual swinging songs. The main focus is on the swing craze, but we will move from the early 900s to nowadays in order to have a wider sight from the roots of jazz to the evolution of swing music and dance. This particular program that you will listen to for 36 episodes is part of the Swing European Network project, co-financed by the European Union. The Italian Swing Dance Academy, whom I am a board member, represents Italy in this three-year project that has 13 partners from 11 different European countries and whose main focus is on the artist's mobility in Europe. So today we're going to have a special program because this is the 8th episode and it's Christmas time, ladies and gentlemen. So I just say, let's start with the first song, 1936, Swinging Them Jingle Bells, Fats Waller.
Thank you. jingle bell, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in the one-horse open sleigh.
What's the matter with him? Them jingle bells got him. They're jingling all the way, look at that.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Look at that.
Jingle, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
All right. Fats Waller and his rhythm, 1936. So Fats Waller was a well-known musician, piano player, organ player, and he wrote a lot of big hits. And like, I don't know how many songs I can name. Amy's Behaving, On a Sack of Rose, just to name two of them. He was on Stormy Weather, the movie of 1943, just few months before he passed. And he was playing with Fletcher Anderson, he was playing with the McKinney Scotland Pickers, and he played all by himself or with his orchestra. He was a great piano player was based in New York. And he died in 1943 while driving from L.A. to Chicago on the train Super Shift, right after a show at the Zanzibar Room in Santa Monica. He died of a heart attack. Now let's move to the West Coast with the Christmas Sleigh Ride of Lloyd Glenn's Combo, 1951.
Thank you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Christmas Sleigh Ride with Lloyd Glenn's Combo, 1951, Los Angeles, West Coast of the United States. Now let's go back to New York on the East Coast with Louis Armstrong, and the name of the song is Cool Yule.
Coney Island to the Sunset Strip. Somebody's gonna make a happy trip tonight while the moon is bright. He's gonna have a bag of crazy toys to give the cornies of the girls and boys all day. Santa comes on day. You come a calling when the snow's the most, when all your cats are sleeping warm as toast, and you gonna flip when old Saint Nick lays a lick on a peppermint stick. You come a flying from a higher place, fill the stocking by the fireplace, so you have a youth that's good. Sunset Strip. Somebody's gonna make a happy trip tonight while the moon is bright. He's gonna have a bag of crazy toys to give the cornies of girls and boys. So dig, Santa comes on big. Come calling when the snow's the most, cats are sleeping warm as toast, and you gonna flip when the old Saint Nick plays a lick on a peppermint stick. You come a flying from the higher place, fill the stockings by the fireplace. So you ever you that's good. Ever you that's good. Yeah, cool yo.
Yeah, I'm a cool, that's you, the great Louis Armstrong at All That Swing. Now let's listen to Lowell Fulson and his orchestra, a song recorded in 1952. Lowell Fulson was a guitar player of the late 40s, early 50s R&B scene on the West Coast. The name of the song is Christmas Party Shuffle.
Thank you.
right, Mr. Lowell Fulson and his orchestra, Christmas Party Shuffle, 1952. And now let's stay on the West Coast with another great, great artist, Mabel Scott and her orchestra. Mabel Scott was a gospel singer, and in 1932, she appeared at the Cotton Club along with Cab Calloway and the Nicholas Brothers. In 1936, she moved to England, where she recorded some songs. And during the World War II, she got back to the West Coast in Los Angeles. Then she had a stint with the Jimmy Lunceford Orchestra. In 1943, she was at the Club Alabama. She had a long residence at the Club Alabama, where the MC was Winona Harris. And then she went back to gospel. Her greatest hits was Boogie Woogie Santa Claus, that we're going to listen to right now. And the other one was Elevator Boogie, that we will listen later on the next episode. Now let's listen to Boogie Woogie Santa Claus, Mabel Scott, 1948.
Track. He's got a rhythm in his feet, a butter, nothing in his sack. He's a boogie-woogie Santa Claus. The boogie-woogie Santa Claus. The boogie-woogie Santa comes to town every Christmas day. He lives up in the mountains like a hermit in a cave. He never had a haircut and he never took a shave. He's a boogie-woogie Santa Claus. The boogie-woogie Santa Claus. The boogie-woogie Santa will boogie all your blues away. Rock, 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 Mr. Santa. Jump, 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 Mr. Santa. He's got no presents for your tree, or candy for your socks, but when he starts to boogie, the whole town rocks.
Mabel Scott, Boogie Woogie Santa Claus, 1948. And now, as usual, let's proceed with some history about the Lindy Hop and swing music together. But we are talking about Miss Norma Miller. So, from I'm going to read you some excerpts from her biography, Swinging at the Savoy, The Memoir of a Jazz Dancer, a book that was written in 1996. So, last time we were reading about a kid named Norma Miller entering the Savoy at 12 years old with Twistmouth George. Okay, the parade was snappy and full of brilliant colors. The winners were picked and the time came for the dances to begin. This was not a dancing contest, but a dancing show held for the matinee. And our appearance was the surprise of the show. Twistmouth brought me to the floor. People were staring and wondering what a mere child was doing on the dance floor. Twistmouth took my hand when they announced Twistmouth and his new partner. He looked at me, patted my hand and said, "Don't worry, just follow me and you'll be okay." As we made our first swing out, it seemed that Twistmouth just lifted me in the air. My feet felt like they never touched the floor. People roared, and at the end we did a step called a flying jig walk. The house came down. At the finish, Twistmouth hoisted me onto his shoulders and paraded me around the floor. People were smiling and patting Twistmouth on the back. I could hear them saying, "Twistmouth is always coming up with something different." That was too much, Twistmouth. There is nothing more expressive than Harlem when they love you, and they loved George Twistmouth Ganaway. He carried me all the way to the door, put me down, and thanked me. Then he busted me on the cheek and led me out of the ballroom. I was as happy as a kid could be. I danced all the way home. Wait till I tell them, I thought. But after thinking it over, I decided not to tell Mama and Dot. They wouldn't believe me anyway. They thought I was a borderline nut, so I decided it to best to keep it as my own secret. I was thrilled. I had just danced with Twistmouth George. He thought I was a good dancer. That night, I went to bed with sugar plums in my head. I had danced in the world's most famous ballroom, the Savoy, and I had danced with the most famous of dancers, Twistmouth George. That was Norma Miller at 12 years old. Now let's proceed with Louis Armstrong and Gordon Jenkins Orchestra, 1952, White Christmas.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white.
Armstrong and White Christmas, singing on the Gordon Jenkins Orchestra, 1952. Now let's step back to the 40s, 1941, a white orchestra, Benny Goodman, with Peggy Lee on voice. The name of the song is Winter Weather.
There's nothing sweeter, finer, when it's nice and cold. I can hold my baby closer to me and collect the kisses that I do me. I love the winter weather, 'cause I got my love to keep me warm.
Can get together. There's nothing sweeter or finer. When it's nice and cold, I can hold my baby closer to me and collect the kisses that are due me. I love the winter weather, 'cause I got my love to keep me warm.
Weather, so the two of us can get together. There's nothing sweeter, finer, when it's nice and cold. I can hold my baby closer to me and collect the kisses that I do me. I love the winter weather, 'cause I got my love to keep me warm.
You're listening to All That Swing by Big Daddy, history, music, culture of the 30s and the 40s. And this is a special episode about Christmas, because it's Christmas time, ladies and gentlemen, hepcats and girls. Girls? No. I mean, a hepcat should have a hep kitten besides him. Anyway, now, the song was Winter Weather, 1941, Benny Goodman and Peggy Lee, along with Art Lund on vocal. Talking about the winter weather, I really dig summer, spring and summer weather, of course, because I live on the beach. And there is a song that it's related, maybe it's not a Christmas song, but it's related to that period. And we're going to listen to this song, sung by Dinah Shore and Buddy Clark with the orchestra of Ted Dale, recorded in 1949. The title of the song is Baby, It's Cold Outside.
You see, it's cold outside.
I really can't
but
stay.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I gotta go
but
away.
But baby, it's cold outside.
This evening has
been hoping that you'd drop in.
So very nice.
I'll hold your hands. They're just like
my
ice.
My mother will start to worry.
Beautiful, what's your
my
hurry?
My father will be pacing the floor.
Listen to the fireplace
now
roar.
Now really, I've got to scurry.
Beautiful, please don't
well,
hurry.
Maybe just a half a drink
put
more.
Put some records on while I pour.
The neighbors might
but
think.
Baby, it's bad out there.
Say, what's in the street?
No cabs to be had out there.
I wish I knew
your
how
eyes are like starlight now.
To break the spell.
I'll take your hat. Your hair looks swell.
I ought to say no, no, no,
mind
sir.
If I move in closer?
At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense in hurting my pride?
I really can't
oh, baby,
stay.
Don't hold out.
Oh,
baby,
but
it's cold outside. Nice and comfortable in here, isn't it, honey?
Yeah. I simply must
but
go.
But baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is
but
no.
But baby, it's cold outside.
The welcome has
how
been
how lucky that you dropped in.
So nice and warm.
Look out the window at that storm.
My sister will be suspicious.
Gosh, your lips look delicious.
My brother will be there at the
waves
door.
Waves upon a tropical shore.
My maiden aunt's mind is vicious.
Your lips are delicious.
Well, maybe just a cigarette more.
Never such a blizzard before.
I gotta get
but
home.
Baby, you'd freeze out there.
Say, lend me your
it's
coat.
It's up to your knees out there.
You've really been
I
grand.
I thrill when you touch my hand.
But don't you see?
How can you do this thing to me?
There's bound to be talk tomorrow.
Think of my lifelong
at
sorrow.
At least there will be plenty implied.
If you caught pneumonia and died,
I really can't
get
stay.
Over that old doubt.
Oh,
baby,
but
it's cold. You know it's cold outside?
Yeah.
Baby, it's cold outside. Dinah Shore and Buddy Clark with the Ted Dale Orchestra, 1949, ladies and gentlemen. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm so glad that you dropped in, because it's cold outside. And now let's go to Europe, my friends. In Zurich, in Switzerland, 1946. The name of the quartet is Ernst Oleragen, and the name of the song is Let It Snow. So 1946. It was a bad winter for Europe in 1946. Not so bad in Switzerland anyway. Hep, hep. Thank you. Ernest Hollerhagen, Let It Snow, Switzerland, 1946. And now let's listen to and meet a new friend, that is Putney Dandridge and his orchestra. So Putney Dandridge was an entertainer in the tradition of Fatswater. Like Bob Howard and Billy Banks, he enjoyed popularity during the 30s, but he fell into almost complete oblivion just a few years later. He was born in 1902, and he began his professional career in 1918 as a pianist with the Drake and Waller Snow Show. Dandridge toured the TOBA circuit, that is a circuit that was for black artists in the States, until 1926. He was then mainly active in Buffalo. In the early 30s, he was regular accompanist of tap dancer Bill Bojangles Robinson. Between 1932 and 1934, Dandridge fronted his own band in the Cleveland area, but then disbanded and moved to New York. In March 1935, he played a residency at the Adrian Rollini's Tap Room, situated in the basement of the Hotel President on West 48th Street. And he also made some recording with the Tap Room Gang in June of that year. In 1935 and 36, Dandridge had the opportunity to record a considerable number of titles under his own name, often accompanied by the finest musicians in town. During this period, he usually worked as a pianist and singer at the Hickory House on the 52nd Street, as well as at other nearby clubs. Dandridge seems to have vanished from the scene in the late 30s when he had no further opportunities to record, and very few details of his later activities are known. It is likely that ill health forced him to retire from the music business in the early 40s. He passed in 1946 at the age of only 44. And now let's listen to this song from 1935, Santa Claus Came in the Spring.
When the skies were blue, I heard his sleigh bells sing-a-ling, the day that I met you. Santa Claus came in the spring, riding along through the daffodils, and I just saw him vanishing across the distant hills. I heard his reindeer on the ground, I thought I caught a glimpse of red, but suddenly I turned around, and there you were instead. What if he did hurry away? Santa Claus came when skies were blue, and now it's Christmas every day, because he brought me you. Turned around, and there were you instead.
40 feet held away. Santa Claus will come back another day, and now it's Christmas every day, because he brought me you.
All right, all right. Putney Dandridge, 1935, Santa Claus Came in the Spring. And along with him, on the piano, there was Teddy Wilson, and on bass, John Kirby, just to name two of them. It was a great combo, this one. Now let's move back to Europe. Copenhagen, in Denmark, 1943, Leo Mathisen Orchestra. The name of the song is Swing the Bells. What a nice song, Swing the Bells, Leo Mathisen Orchestra, Copenhagen, Denmark, 1943. Okay, now let's proceed with Norma. It was 1932, so Norma was 12 years old, and swing music had become the music of our generation. There was a local ballroom called the Renaissance, which had matinee for young people. The band was Vernon Andres. We're going to listen to that band later on. It was the first time I would dance the Lindy, the dance I'd been watching at the Savoy from our fire escape. It was exciting, energetic, and definitely my kind of dance. I loved the music, and I loved the dancing. The Lindy Hop was one swinging dance. This was the way to a dancing career. I began to live for Sundays at the Rennie. The Renaissance Club. Sonny Ashby was my partner, and our best friend Billy Leach would go with us every week. there was Frankie Manning, William Downes, and his sister Joyce. One of these contests was being held at the Apollo Theater. Ralph Cooper, the MC, had started the contest on Thursdays. There was a competition between four black teams from the Savoy and four white teams from the Roseland Ballroom. The winner would get a week's work at the Apollo. When Sonny and I reported to the theater, we were told to go downstairs to the rehearsal hall in the basement. We were just a couple of kids and no one thought we had a chance to win. They seemed a bit irritated that we took one of the four Savoy slots, but not the least bit threatened. It was in the rehearsal hall that I saw Frank Schiffman for the first time. He ran the theater. He was a very small man who looked like a professor, but he had a lot of power and he ran a tight ship. So, when it was our turn to dance, I was nervous as a cat. We were well rehearsed and we knew our routine, but we had a strong competition. Being kids gave Sonny and me an advantage. The audience was on our side as soon as we swung out. The minute we hit the stage, the crowd let out a yell to let us know they were with us. The house came down and we won big that night. The prize money was $25. We left the theater walking on air. 1932, Miss Norma Miller, 12 years old, ladies and gentlemen. And now let's listen to Fattest Man in Town with Bob Chester and his orchestra, 1950.
Comes the fattest man in town. He's more than 60 inches round. Never in a hurry, never has a frown. Doesn't ever worry, long as there's a reindeer round. Here comes the fattest man in town. Wonder whose chimney he'll slide down. There's only one way traffic when he comes to town. Make way for the fattest man in town.
Bob Chester and his orchestra, 1950, the fattest man in town. Now let's listen to Eartha Kitt with Henry René Orchestra, a song recorded in 1953. Eartha Kitt was an actress, a singer, a dancer, an activist, and a comedian and an author. She had a great hit with the song we're going to listen right now, that is Santa Baby, and along with Ceci Bonne, and more later on. Orson Welles, the great actor, and not only actor, defined her like the most exciting woman in the world. And I believe it. I do believe it. And she was. You can see her in a Broadway musical. You could see her in a Broadway musical, Carib Song of 1948. And later on television as a Catwoman with Batman, 1967. Catwoman was her ticket. And being an activist gave her some troubles with the CIA, with the U.S. government, as usual. A black woman activist? Huh. Man, you kidding? So it was the end of her career when the CIA puts out a false and defamatory dossier about her. Now let's listen to this beautiful song that is Santa Baby.
Boom, 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 boom.
Santa Baby, just slip a sable under the tree for me. Been an awful good girl, Santa Baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa Baby, a 54 convertible to light blue. I'll wait up for you, dear Santa Baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Think of all the fun I've missed. Think of all the fellas that I haven't kissed. Next year I could be just as good if you check off my Christmas list. Santa Baby, I want a yacht, and really that's not a lot. Been an angel all year, Santa Baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa honey, one little thing I really need, the deed to a platinum mine, Santa Baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa cutie, and fill my stocking with a duplex and checks. Sign your X on the line, Santa cutie, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Come and trim my Christmas tree with some decorations bought at Tiffany. I really do believe in you. Let's see if you believe in me. Santa Baby, forgot to mention one little thing, a ring. I don't mean on the phone, Santa Baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry, tonight.
Oh man, Eartha Kitt, Santa Baby, hurry down the chimney to me. Wow. I wish he rushed down the chimney. Okay, let's listen now to Roy Milton. He was Indian American. I mean, his grandmother was a Chickasaw from the Indian reservation. And he lived there and before moving to Tulsa, Oklahoma. In the late 20s, he was with Ernie Fields, a singer, as a singer and a drummer. And then with a territory band, that was the Royal Entertainment. In 1933, he set up the Solid Sanders with Camille Howard on the piano. But he began recording in the 40s. So the first recording between his 40s, 40 and 45, the first song. And the first hit was in 1945, it was Royal Milton Blues, and then Hop, Skip and Jump, Information Blues, Reeling and Rocking, and so on. So it's just great jive, great rhythm and blues with Roy Milton and his Christmas Time Blues.
Far away. Yes, it's Christmas time, and my baby is so far away. Oh, how I wish I had my baby here with me on Christmas Day. Santa Claus, please tell him this one thing for me. Yes, if you see Santa Claus, please tell him this one thing for me. If I've been a bad fellow, no, I didn't intend to be. High on some Christmas tree. So Santa Claus can bring my sweet baby back to me.
Roy Milton, 1950, Christmas Time Blues. And we are at the end of the episode, eighth episode of this All That Swing, Music, Culture and History with Big Daddy, and All That Swing about 30s and 40s. And this program is part of the Swing European Network project, co-financed by the European Union. And we'll be seeing you next month. And the last song we're going to listen to comes from the Billy Bros Swing Orchestra, from their record Swing Italiano 2003, Swinging Bells. Hep, hep.